Well, there's something special about life advice from an Eastern philosophy.
First wash all the car, then wax.
Wax. Wait, what do I have to wash all the car?
Remember, dear, no question.
Yeah, but...
Right. Wax on, right hand. Wax off, left hand.
Well, our next guest didn't get any car care tips from his Mr. Miyagi, but what a Thai monk told him saved him from a downward spiral of gang violence and drugs.
Yeah, he's proof it's never too late to change. Luke Kennedy is now a businessman, a motivational speaker and a mentor. And we're very lucky that Luke joins us now this morning. Good morning, Luke. Thanks for taking the time
for us.
I was reading your story online. Geez, I think you're fascinating. But for context for people, as a younger man, you were involved in a street gang. You were stabbed twice at one stage and you had a run with alcohol and drugs as well. Can you give us a little bit of your story? Tell us how you got involved in that scene.
Yeah, so there was many things that took me down that path. But looking back, one in particular, growing up, I was an overweight kid. I was a big kid and I had some pretty deep insecurities about myself. And during that time, my dad and brother were both boxers and I'd go to the gym and watch the boxers, watch my dad train, and I could see the way boxers and fighters were respected and the way they were looked up to and people did things for them. And as a young kid, I was like, oh, I want a bit of that respect. But later on, I just went about the wrong way. I went about it in the streets, and for 8 years of my life, I was a lost boy looking to fit in, looking to impress people, and, yeah, just looking for belonging, really. And that led me down to the drugs and alcohol too, because I was trying to silence what was going on up here, but doing that with drugs and alcohol made it 10 times worse.
So you're amazingly lucky to have got through all that without dying or possibly even killing someone else.
Yeah, yeah. And at the time, you know, I thought I was lucky because when I was stabbed, it was a punctured lung and it just missed my heart. And I was close to getting revenge attacks as well. So, yes, look back then, I thought I was lucky. But now looking back at those times, I think, you know, I was being looked after. I was being guided. And now I know because I was being looked after, because I had to come out the back end, and now I'll be able to help our youth get through some hard times that they may be going through. So I feel that's why I was being looked after, for this purpose of what I'm doing now.
Oh, most definitely. And you're definitely doing that. And it's very, very unfortunate what you went through as well. I heard that you were about to sign up for the Navy and you decided to take a trip to Thailand before. Was that just for a holiday? I mean, things didn't go to plan when you got to Thailand there either, did it? What happened there?
Correct. So in 2008, I turned my life around through boxing. So I got into my boxing, I lost 50 kilos and life was going great. However, all the changes I was doing was making changes in the physical space. I wasn't really changing anything in my heart or in my head and in my spirit. So furthering changes in the physical space, I decided to join the Navy. And as a proud career, something I could look a good purpose of mine. So I joined the Navy. And I go to Thailand, there's a last little party, a last little hurrah. And the first night I'm in Thailand, I party hard and I disrespected, I suppose, the Thailand people, the culture and the land there. And disrespecting that, I paid a pretty heavy price. I was hit by a truck and broke two bones in my leg, my hip, my pelvis and my jaw. So other chaotic events happened through that time. And then I was visited by a monk in hospital. And this monk showed me why all these chaotic events were happening in my life. A lot of it was me suppressing, not wanting to look at my demons, my emotions, my suffering. And by suppressing it, they'd pop out in other areas of my life. They popped out in drug and alcohol abuse. They popped out in me being in a relationship for 3 months and then closing up my heart and getting out. So this monk forced me to look at my suffering so I could look at it, understand it, and move through it rather than run away from it.
So now you mentor others. Tell us, what stories do you hear?
Yeah, there's a bunch. There's a broad range of stories, because at the moment, I'm sure you guys know it. You may know, like, maybe a family member, a friend, but we've all experienced it. Something's not working at the moment with mental health. You know, there needs to be some big changes in society. There needs to be a shift. And especially with our youth, we're losing kids. And a lot of the kids that are here are suffering. And I feel there's many different reasons behind that, but I feel one of them is the disconnection from each other, the disconnection from themselves, the disconnection maybe from their culture, their spirit, whatever that may be. So the disconnection there, and I feel in my talks, through my cool stories, I like to get the connection through that, and then I weave the messages out through that talk of of resilience and the understanding of the importance of getting back to who they really are deep down. And the feedback I've gotten has been great. Some students have made some huge changes, but there's also been ones where they're confident enough to speak to me, so they'll message me and talk to me through, and I'll be up all night speaking through some acute suicidal thoughts and actions. So there's a broad range, the positive stuff and the not so positive stuff, but I'm there for it. For all of it.
Do you know, I find you so fascinating, mate. I think you're so important, and it's so important what you're doing. I hope you see the value in yourself and everything. You know, I know it's very difficult to talk about, and you can see you're getting quite emotional and passionate about it now, but we need more people like you. Luke's book is called Sex, Drugs and a Buddhist Monk, and it's out now. Luke, thanks for all that you continue to do, and thanks for joining us this morning. We appreciate you.
Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity.
Of course. Thank you, and take care.
And remember, if you need help, Lifeline is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on 13 11 14.